I want to bring back CTV News political commentator and former conservative MP Lisa Raitt. You know, Lisa, it's interesting to hear from Mr. Ford because he was persona non grata during the federal election. Word is at the behest of Mr. Scheer's people. What do you make of his statement?
I think it's very gracious and it's very true. I believe that the premier does wish the best for Andrew and for Jill and for the entire family. And I'm really happy to see that he's one of the first ones out there to congratulate Andrew on his time as leader. I thought it was very classy and I'm really happy to see the premier engage.
We're hearing talk that conservative funds were used to pay for Mr. Scheer's children's private school education in Ottawa, offsetting the cost of what it would cost in Regina, and this was not disclosed to party members. What's your take on that?
Well, it is news to me. I did not know about it, but nor would I necessarily know about it. I don't sit on that fund, the fund that actually collects the money for the campaign from volunteers. What I do know is this, though, that is going to cause a lot of difficulty for some members of my party. They are not going to look at it as being an appropriate use of funds. Some people will think it's appropriate that you have to support the leader, you buy him clothes, you buy him makeup, you have to make sure that his family is being looked after. So there's going to be a difference of opinion, but in reality, with Andrew resigning and stepping down, it really isn't a bone of contention anymore at the moment. What we should be focusing on is moving forward, coming up with a new process to find a new leader, and of course, encouraging everyone out there who have been thinking about running, well, now's your time. Get your name out. Call CTV. Let them know you're interested, because if you're early in the race, you do have a better chance of winning. So that's my advice.
Okay, I'll get back to that as well, but I just want to touch on this as well,
yeah.
On the Conservative front. Why wouldn't he announce that if he agreed to it? Because it's speaks to hypocrisy, Lisa. Mm. That, this is a man who led the charge against Justin Trudeau during the SNC-Lavalin, called him a hypocrite, if I'm not mistaken, almost to his face. Yet here he is accepting money from the Conservative Party to put his kids in private school.
Yeah, and that is something that he's going to have to answer for. And as I said to you, it's going to have some members of my party incredibly upset and not appreciative. And quite frankly, I think everyone's a little bit shocked by it. Mm-hmm. When I first heard about the rumor early this morning, it was everyone saying, well, it's just a rumor, it can't be true. And I think people are going to have to sort through their feelings on it and what it means to them. But as I said, with Andrew leaving as leader, it really isn't an issue for the Conservative Party anymore. It is something that he will have to speak to, and the party has spoken to it. And going forward, we've got to think about what the process is going to be for the new campaign.
Sure.
And what's going to be happening. And I keep saying we, forgetting the fact that I'm no longer part of the caucus there in Ottawa, but I'm very much not a member of parliament, and that's just my observation, that I can see some members, I know some members, would not be happy about this revelation.
And to be clear, the party has said this was all above board. There was no misuse of funds. It was just in terms of legal or illegal. It's just that it was not disclosed.
You know what the adage is in that is when you're explaining, you're losing.
Well, there you go.
And it's an issue. And clearly what we should be talking about is Andrew's accomplishments in the past number of years. Instead, what we're talking about is this last piece of information that came out. And that's a shame.
Yeah. That would likely be the straw that broke the camel's back. If that writing is on the wall and he's got all these, people calling for his head anyway, this is the time to go.
Well, and as I said before, it makes a lot of sense to do it now. He gets to speak to the House of Commons in order to give his comments. And then for the next 6 weeks, he gets to go away.
Lisa Raitt, always good to have you on. Appreciate your insight. I know we'll be talking, I'm sure, much more over the next little while as we head towards a leadership convention. Thank you, Lisa Raitt, joining me.